We will go ahead and get started. So we've shared the slides for this meeting in advance because we're hoping to get your input on a couple aspects of some programmatic planning we're doing related to the data dashboards and to the performance measure that we plan to launch. And if you haven't had a chance to look at those in advance, no problem. We will have 10 minutes call to explain and go through it as well. And we're lucky to have Dr. Lauren Oshman here today, who's going to talk through the performance measure portion of the meeting. But I'm going to get started and talk a little bit about the pre-populated reports and the practice level views that we wanted to discuss with you. So, as we've shared in previous meetings where we had Laria present about the Dashboard 2.0 that we're building out, we're working to create pre-populated reports as a part of the 2.0 build-out. So, previously, we've had the summary measures tab, but any kind of analysis that you were doing there, you were selecting the comparisons, the different variables that you wanted to look at. Whereas with this, we want to create some reports that are pre-built and standard that you can click on. It's going to run them for you. It should give you an easier and quicker way to get some of the comparison data that you want versus like the quarterly reports that we send out, which we still will, but those don't have that same kind of on-demand aspect of these. So as we're thinking about building out this pre-populated report section, we wanted to make sure that we were getting your input on what you wanted to see for this, because we want to make sure that we're allocating resources appropriately and that we're starting with the reports that are of most value to you. So that's what we wanted to talk a little bit about today. So the different kinds of reporting that we want to include, we'll want to take a look at trends over time, so including some HEDIS metrics, prescribing rates, et cetera, so you can see how the practices and how your PO has improved over certain time frames. We want to do comparison reports so that you can look practice to the collaborative, your practices to the region, and kind of see different comparisons where you're falling. The data completeness report. So that's been something that you all know we're making an effort towards understanding better and trying to identify where there's gaps in the data so that we can track to the root of where those discrepancies are and work towards ultimately having more complete data in our dashboards. And this will also ultimately be where we build additional reports like on health equity and social determinants of health and more things as our data sources hopefully increase over time. So, like we said, we want to include you in the decision-making process with this and help us prioritize what reports we build and the data that's included on these reports. So, before I dive into this first poll and we launch it and get your input on it, Laria, is there anything that I didn't mention in the last few slides or that you want to expand upon before we talk about the poll?
No, I think that was great, Jackie. Thank you for covering that. I think the only thing I'll add is the design team is really excited to get this feedback from you, and then we'll translate that into versions of the reports that can be shared with our partner MDC when they build this out. So feedback that you give us today will really be directly incorporated in how we prioritize which reports they build out first. And we are hoping to continue expanding on this over time. This won't be the limits of the reports we have, but we really appreciate you taking the time to vote. And Jackie, just so you know, the poll includes this slide and the next slide on the same one. So if you want to introduce both, and then I'll launch it.
Perfect. That sounds great. Thank you, Laria. So for the poll that we're going to do, like Laria just mentioned, we're going to be launching them at the same times. What we want to do, these are the different topics that could be covered like as part of these reports that we build out. And we want you to choose like of these, what are the top two that are of most interest to you? Like Laria said, this is just our starting point. We're going to continue to expand on this and add over time, but we want to ensure that the first few things that we create are the ones that are of most interest to you and of most use to you. So we have these all listed on here. I won't go over them in detail, but you'll be able to see all the options on the poll. And like Laria said, I'll mention the second one too. So we're split this into topics and features. And so, as far as the features component, we really want to understand what's most useful to you as to how you'll be using these reports. So, are you more interested in comparing your providers or your practices, for example, or to see how your PO is doing overall? Do you want to be able to prioritize looking at trending data over time? So, this will kind of help us think about when building out the features, what we want to prioritize and look at in more detail. So, with that, Laria, if we can launch the poll, and if anyone has questions, feel free to put them in the chat. We'll give you a few minutes just to answer and respond with what you'd like to see.
Yep, and the poll should be launched now. Hopefully you can see that. And we wrote this in here, but if you feel like something is missing, if there's something else you would like to see, either related to topics or features, please feel free to select other and then put it in the chat or send us an email with that and we will add that in. And Jackie, I'll let you know when 80 to 90% of people have responded, and then I can end the poll and share the results. Okay, it looks like we've had a majority of people submit, and I don't see any more coming in. So I'm going to go ahead and end this poll and share the results.
Much area. Okay, so everyone should be able to see these results on their screen. It looks like for the first question, got a lot of varying responses, but the highest being around looking at prescribing trends related to the CGM, to medications, how those have changed over time, and select HEDIS measure trends as the primary topics. Less interest in like the data reporting rates and the SDOH. So this is absolutely something that we'll take back. We'll consider in determining those initial reports that we want to build out. And as far as features that are the highest interest to you, it looks like ability to see current A1C, controlled versus uncontrolled rates, and the ability to compare amongst practices in the PO are some of the highest chosen options there. So if anyone has any additional comments or things that we didn't include in as options here that you want to share, please feel free to put those in the chat. Otherwise, what we're going to do, we'll take this back. We'll talk with our design team and with MVC about what we want these initial reports to look like and keep you updated throughout this process as we have with the dashboard development and let you know what those initial reports will be and how we'll build those out. And thanks, Gina. Gina mentioned that some of the options seem duplicative, so I was having a hard time thinking. Thanks for sharing that. Appreciate it. That's good to know, and we'll think about that and maybe revise the poll a little bit for the next one so it could be more straightforward. I appreciate that. And Laria, the timeline for the pre-populated reports, just to reiterate on that, are we still thinking that it's going to be around October as well with like the rest of the launch of summary measures, just to give everyone an idea of timeline?
Yeah, that's what we're hoping for. It may just be one at that point that we release as sort of a test version, and then we'll continue to expand out sort of our portfolio of them, but that is the plan.
Great. So then we just have one final question for you before I turn it over to Dr. Ashman. So we want to talk about dashboard user levels for the summary measure. So as you know, right now there's PO level users, which is all of you on this call, where you can see all of the practices within your PO, all of the providers within those practices, and then right now a practice level user where they can look at their practice, they can compare themselves to the PO, and then they can look at the providers there. But there's not really a lot of other comparisons that they can make right now besides provider to provider. And so what we wanted to do and wanted to run by you all initially to get your input on it. So we wanted to talk about potentially looking at sharing de-identified data with the practices about the other practices in their PO. So what this would look like is this example here where it says practice user and the name's de-identified. So they'd have their facility, let's say, and then everything else would show up as other facility one, other facility two, other facility three, so that they could see where they rank to other practices in your PO, just kind of get an understanding of where they're excelling, where they may need to improve. Whereas you, as the PO, you would always have that practice name identified. So you would be able to see, like, oh, it's this practice versus the blinded version of it. And so we wanted to get your input on another poll on if you're comfortable with us sharing blinded data at that practice level user approach. And we would really encourage this because we think that what we're ultimately going to launch with performance measures, which we'll get into shortly, are going to be PO level measures. So really how they're performing compared to other practices in your PO is really relevant information to them. And it is going to be at that blinded level. So they're not going to be able to look and say, oh, it's this practice that's performing the worst, or we're performing the best and this one's the worst. So it's going to be at a completely blinded level. And we do want to get to that point where that information is shared. We think that it'll be motivating in a sense for them to be able to look and have that drive for improvement. So we thought that that might be something helpful for them and wanted to just get your sign up on it. So we're going to do another poll and say, just get your take on it. Are you comfortable with us having blinded practice level data for users? And I think if there is concern, we'd like to discuss it.
Great. Thank you, Jackie. The poll should be live.
Awesome. I'm going to go ahead and end it. It looks like we have unanimous agreement on sharing those. So that's great news. If anyone does have any reservations that they'd like to discuss with us in more detail, please reach out. We're happy to have a conversation with you about it. But we're glad that you're in agreement that this is something that would be useful, that we'd want to share with the practices. So with that, I'm going to stop sharing. We're going to switch what we're focusing on a little bit, and we're going to have Dr. Ashman introduce the performance measure that we're considering sharing with the, or considering as our initial performance measure with the collaborative. Dr. Ashman, you should have the link to those slides in your chat right now so that you could share directly from your screen, and I will hand it over to you.
So, how do I sound?
Much better. Dr. Ashman lost her voice yesterday, but you, it sounds like you've made a full recovery.
I feel confident. I think if people are okay with a little bit of frog speak, then I'm okay speaking. I am going to do a presenter view and then ask Jackie, how do I make presenter view go on two different views again?
What was that? How do you do presenter view and have it on a different screen?
Got it. Okay, I think I'm good. And then if anyone wants to put in the chat how I can do presenter view, I'm just kidding. Okay, so now you're seeing that, and I
You're a few slides ahead though, so go back a little bit.
get a sneak peek. Okay, this is good. Yay, it's okay.
Yep, there you go.
Perfect. So I am really, really interested to get your feedback about what we as a collaborative want to use as a performance measure and how much of our VBR should be allotted to a performance measure. And the reason for this is that we're really starting to get robust enough data about our Blue Cross Blue Shield and BCN patient population that I think we really can move forward to having clear data about some of our important quality aspects of diabetes care. And then really, picking a landmark and moving forward on improving. And ultimately, that is what we want to be as a quality collaborative. We don't want to just work on quality assurance and staying the same. We really want to push things forward. And so please do jump in with your feedback as we go through this. So this is what we've proposed. There's a couple of reasons. So looking at A1C control, we know that glycemic control is relevant to a number of different diabetes complications. The lower your A1C, the less risk there is of diabetic nephropathy, kidney disease, eye disease, numerous other complications, cardiovascular disease, and frankly, the complications of dysglycemia itself. And we know for people with really poor control, A1C of 9, 10, 11, Those are the folks who are much more likely to end up in the emergency room. Kind of a signal for me for patients who have social determinants of health risks, other things going in on in their life that we really need to help them. And so we knew from starting the collaborative that we were going to have to pick a performance measure. And so in this discussion, my request for you is not do we or don't we, but how do we work together to make this really something that improves quality and just checks a box. So this is going to be separate from participation measures, and we change those participation member measures a little bit each year to focus on what we really want to improve. Our proposal is to have participation be 3% and performance be 2% so that you could earn both of them, one or the other, but it wouldn't be contingent on both. So this is just for our primary care practices. Our specialty care practices will move to a performance measure later because their VBR year is different. And so we plan to look at A1C over 8 and getting patients to 8.0% or less. So why do we choose this? We chose this because you can use numerous different interventions, including all of the tools that A1C makes that we MCT2D make available to you and other tools at your disposal without being directly required to prescribe specific medications or have a CGM available to a patient to control their A1C. And this is exactly aligned with our HEDIS measure. So I was just in a Michigan Medicine meeting this morning where we were looking at our HEDIS data for A1C 8 and under. And so this aligns with what you're already doing. And this is one of the most robustly reported data pieces that we have. So we have the most patients, the most data on A1C. So how we're doing as a total, and what you'll see here is the rate of control on the y-axis and years on the x-axis. Year one, we were enrolling practices, doing education, but not really pushing forward any of our initiatives. Year two, starting to do more, looking at our quality initiatives in year three, trying this process improvement activities at your POs. And so what we can appreciate is that those numbers are decreasing every year. And so it's really good to know that we're already doing great work on this as a collaborative. The next thing I want to show you is the differences between POs. So these are all blinded. I don't remember who is A and who is AC. But look at this count of patients over years. And we can see that from one PO, we have only 21 patients being sent to us. So that is clearly a problem with data missingness and reporting data through the different data reporting mechanisms we have. And for POAC, we have 6,500 patients. So we can appreciate that one of our goals over the next year is going to be to ensure that you all have the support that you need to make sure that you are sending us this data. We know we're picking it up because for some of your POs, we have a robust group of patients. And then you can see the percent control over on the right. So for POA, we just got one person to improve and we're there. But we can see a variety of different rates of control. Even if we look at the POs where we've got robust data, between 8%, 15%, 20% for one. And so we can see that we're doing slightly different, and that probably has to do with our practices, our communities, and our patients. So we want to get your feedback, and we're going to do that at this meeting. I can see a lot already in the chat. It may be too complex for you to share here, or you may need some time to really think about how this is going to affect your PO and how to be successful. And we can set up individualized meetings to get your feedback. We're thinking about using a cutoff of 9. And then we looked at the data and we just don't have enough patients. So I think that cutoff of 8 is really the sweet spot of improving patient care plus the data that we have. And then we have yet to determine the baseline rate and what that improvement goal would be. So this is really the time to have you share with us what you're already looking at in terms of reporting for HEDIS, what you're already doing to improve, and what you think is important in terms of those two things. And then we'll continue to socialize this as we come to those kind of final details and vet that baseline and improvement goal. As you hopefully know, we do have a steering committee made up of representatives from our patient advisory board, you at the PO level and at the practice level, and they are kind of our final vetting measure to make sure that everyone is in agreement about this. And then performance matter has to be signed off by Blue Cross before we can move forward. So we have a couple of discussion points over here, and I'm going to pass it along to Jackie to facilitate discussion so that you don't have to hear me any longer. And then excited to get your feedback.
Yeah, absolutely. So there's been some conversation in the chat that I can recap, and then we'll go through these discussion questions. So there's been questions about like the year that this would start and that it would be effective and what the measurement period would be. And like we said in this chat, we haven't determined the specifics of the measure yet because as a first step, we really wanted to run this as a concept by you and see if there's buy-in, if there was concern, where their issues are with it. And so what we'll do following this conversation and the PO call that we have this next Monday is kind of take that back and start thinking about some of those more specifics, what the exact measurement period will be, what the baseline rate is, and what that time frame will be, what the measurement time frame will be, what the goal will be, how to lock in and keep that patient population stable so that you're being judged fairly on it. A couple other questions. Will you only be using data from the MDC dashboard to determine the baseline and improvement rate? That is our primary data source. And yes, we're going to plan to use the MDC dashboards because we wanted to, at the launch of this collaborative, not have you all submit manual data to us. And so part of the point of choosing this measure that Dr. Ashman had highlighted earlier was looking at data availability and what we have and what is being submitted. A1C is more reliably submitted across the board and incorporated into the dashboards. So we wanted to use that as a rate. And then can you confirm the population? It would be Blue Cross Commercial, Blue Care Network, and their Medicare Advantage population. So it would be the same populations that you currently see reflected in the dashboards.
This question, we had talked about whether it should be CQI level or practice level, sorry, or PO level or practice level. And I think we felt and happy to get your feedback about this, that in order to really incentivize change and improvement at the PO level, that we felt comfortable doing this at the PO level.
Yeah, and to add to that, so we were thinking the PO level for a couple of reasons. A, just you have a smaller locus of control there, or a larger locus of control, I suppose, with their practices versus the collaborative overall. And with a collaborative level measure, there's always the risk of not meeting it, and then the whole collaborative doesn't get that additional VBR. So I think that we would ultimately one day like to include a collaborative level measure, and we'll think about what that looks like and what makes sense to include on that. Though, if the entire feeling of you as the POs is that you'd rather see it at a collaborative level and kind of take that risk of meeting it versus not meeting it, we'd definitely take that under consideration.
And then Jackie, to the percent improvement, I think things we're thinking about are what is the best anyone can do? Should you just be staying the same and not improving anymore once you hit a bar of improvement, or what percent to improve? And it's this balance between being clinically significant versus a 0.1% improvement, or having partial credit for staying the same versus not getting worse. And so that I think will happen in the next few months, and we'll have more to say at the collaborative wide meeting as we look at this data deeper. But love to get your feedback about it.
Yeah, Kathy, to expand on that question too, I think what we are leaning towards, at least right now, and let me know if you disagree, Dr. Ashman, but I don't think we would have the same percent like overall at a collaborative. We would calculate individual percents at the PO level and say, okay, your starting point is here. We want you to improve X percent on your starting point. But like Dr. Ashman said, this is the kind of things that we're going to go back and discuss and look at in more detail, but we're thinking probably individualized improvement targets based on where you're starting. And also to Dr. Ashman's point, consideration of when are you at a maximum level of improvement? We can't really ask for more than that.
And I think this piece of balancing, we want everyone to be able to earn this VBR. And we also want it to mean something in terms of making appreciable, meaningful change in the lives of your patients. So we don't want to make it too hard to meet. We just want to make it mean something.
And Mary asked in the chat, are there considerations on how to incorporate time and range and other CGM metrics as they're becoming more integrated into care? It's definitely something that we want to include in our dashboards, but that we're going to have much less data on that than we are going to have on A1C. So it's likely not something that we're going to set up as a performance measure. But I was just meeting with Blue Cross earlier today, and they were talking about how GMI, I think it's GMI, right? Dr. Ashman, the measure from CGMs can be submitted in lieu of A1C as like a measure of glucose control and diabetes. So we may look at like how that data is submitted, but not at the point that we'd use it as a performance measure at this point.
I think the only thing to add to that is I'm worried, unless we picked the best of the two, most of my patients that have really good looking A1Cs, their CGM measurement shows significant hyperglycemia. So we want to be really careful. And that might be this idea of a performance year versus just a measurement year. We may start to measure it without grading you on performance.
And then we had in the chat for performance tracking, MDC dashboard seems fair, but it's so lagged to be actionable for sites, speculating we may already be into the measurement period. PO level seems fair, can operationalize that at the site. The lack of alignment with HEDIS, especially the threshold 8 versus 9, isn't ideal, but could be approached generically as work your HEDIS list. Yeah, thank you, Gina, for that feedback. Yeah, the challenge with the dashboards, and we've been working on improving the lag time, and of course, I don't think it will be improved to the point that you're looking for, like prior to this measure being launched. Unfortunately, it is the only data source that we have as a collaborative. Like, unless we were to ask you all to manually submit data, I don't think we can provide better information. That said, if you as POs have information that you want to use for like tracking the performance on it, we're not requiring that you like use the dashboards for that performance tracking. And if you have better measures, absolutely operationalize those. This is what we have is like kind of the common denominator across the collaborative, and that's the data that we have. So it's ultimately what we'll have to measure off of.
To take back to our team, Jackie, though, is looking at how we manage that last 3 months of the performance year and getting you data, but not expecting you to manage something with data that you don't have. So that's actually really crucial for us to think about the start and finish.
That makes sense. Do you have anything else you want to add, Dr. Ashman, about like A1C, HEDIS using the last value of the year, and if we don't align with that calendar year, how will we determine improvements when there may be fluctuating values over time?
So I think it just has to do with my expectation that this group, the Blue Cross Blue Shield group, may be performing better than your overall HEDIS population, because my sense is low-income Medicaid tend to have higher A1C values in general. And the idea of using a closed population, meaning that whoever is in your MDC dashboard at the beginning of the year, that is who you will be asked to improve on. Not your fault if someone leaves the practice. But if someone enters your practice with poor control a month before the year ends, we would not be expecting you then to magically control them within a month. If you have other ideas about how you've managed that with other payment programs or VPR programs, that would be really helpful to share.
Really appreciate all this feedback. It's given us a lot of things to kind of take back and think about and inform how we want to set this up and what's going to be the most fair to you all. I know it's 2:30 right now. If anyone has any last comments, please feel free to put them in the chat, and we will get that Calendly's set up and sent out to you all shortly too, just with a short like 15 to 30 minute slots. So if there are specific things you want to discuss or share with us about it, we'll have that time set aside to talk with you too, and really appreciate your thoughts on this and on the reports for the dashboard. Right, seeing no more comments, we will go ahead and wrap up. Thank you, Laria, for your work on the pre-populator reports, and Dr. Ashman for talking us through the performance measure.
Thanks, everyone, for your feedback.
And go rest your voice. Thanks, everybody.